It's about to go down. What's poppin', Fight World? You rocking with your boy, man, Lomachenko versus your boy, my boy, Theo Fame, man. Listen, people, this is gonna be a fight to remember, man. We're about to give you full blow by blow, full coverage of this fight, man. I need you to understand something, man. My money's on the wood, and I'm picking Lomachenko for this fight, man. You know, I did some research on this fight, man, you know, because this is a highly, highly contested fight. Both guys got a lot of different skills, but when I was watching the fight and I was asking myself, look, we got to figure out what type of fighter can beat Lomachenko. What are the flaws of Lomachenko? What are his habits? What are the things that he do that you can pick up on and Theo can capitalize on, man? And I just said, okay, look, your boy Lomachenko, he's a pressure fighter. He likes to come forward, right? So what do you do with a guy that likes to come forward that can move the way he move? I mean, his footwork is deadly, but what I'm trying to tell you is this. Man, Lomachenko is a pressure fighter. He loves to come forward, right? For a short guy, you wouldn't want him to be a pressure fighter because he doesn't have long arms, but his footwork put him in position to make you miss and make you pay while he's on a different angle, while you're going to be swinging for the fences, and he's going to have a direct shot to the body upstairs. What I'm trying to tell you is this. He's a pressure fighter. He's been successful because he's a mid-range hooker. So he needs to come forward. He needs to be in the pocket. He needs to be close to you. He needs to be at that mid-range to throw his shots. There's one thing to move your feet. There's one thing to have great footwork and great hand speed, but it's another thing to get to the target. So in order for him to do that, he needs to be close up. So what can Theo do? So those were the things that I was watching. Like every time, every fight, he was just in the pocket. He was coming to the pocket. He wanted to be in the pocket. He need to be in the pocket. So I said, okay, Theo needs to stand there with him. He needs to punch with him. Forget about the pundits and the analysts that tell you that Lomachenko can't fight him on his back foot. So push him back and you'll have success. It ain't going to be that easy because of the footwork. You understand what I'm telling you? And his footwork is elite. It's different. He's side to side. He's switch hitting. He's switch angling. He's giving you different looks every minute of every second of the minute of the round. So it's difficult to just push him back, throw your jab, because Lomachenko was also a great counter puncher because he uses his footwork to put you out of position. So taking him, pushing him back ain't gonna happen. We got about 5 more minutes. All right, okay, just talking. All right, people, the fight about to go down. I need you to understand something. So Theo is going to need to punch with Lomachenko. He needs to punch with him because he has the power, right? He needs to stay at that mid-range, let that hook go to the body, and stay in front of Lomachenko as you guys meet in the middle. Don't take steps backwards. Don't fight on your back foot because that's Lomachenko's strength. When he pushes you back, he dictate the pace. So what can Theo do? What can Theo Fame do to be successful? Punch with him, right? Stay in front of him because that's what Loma does well. He stays in front of you. He's like, what's shaking? What's good? What you gonna do? What you gonna do? He put that pressure and pressure bust pipes. And he understands that. You understand me? There's a lot of flaws in your boy Loma, but you gotta be able to exploit them and understand it. So when Theo said he don't watch film, I'm saying, well, how could you know a guy's habits? How would you know, you know, if Loma don't pick up his left hand when he throw the right or these things? You have to watch film. But I believe he do. And I think he thinks that that's something that you can say and makes you popular or makes you elite. But it doesn't. It makes you sound stupid because everybody needs to watch film. Point blank, period. You need to know your opponent's habits, right? And his weaknesses so you can exploit them. So you can look for them when the fight happens, right? So stay in front of them. Don't worry about the pushing back, but stay in front of him. Let your hands go as Loma let his go. But you have to be in front of him when you do so. Stay in his range. You see what I'm saying? And I think that if Theo can do that, he will have some success and Loma will feel the power and then have to switch to plan B or plan C because we haven't really seen any other type of tactic other than, you know, come forward, use angles, you know, get beside you, use different, you know, ways to get to the target as far as with Loma is going down. But I just feel like, you know, Theo, although there's a game plan for him to win, although he does have the power, and if he hits with Loma, Loma's going to go down. I'm telling you that right now. But I don't think he has the maturity to under the big lights, you know, under the pressure that Loma's going to present to him, man. You know, when I was watching these guys face off and the little thing said, was that Wednesday? You know, I just seen his mannerisms and the way he was speaking. He looked nervous to me. You know, Lomachenko was stern. He answered direct questions. He didn't fidget around. He's about his business, man. And that tells you a lot about a person, man. You know, what you can look at them, how they outside mannerisms are. You can see how their mannerisms going to be when they get in the ring. Trust me when I tell you, man. You ever look the punk in his eyes and say, what's shaking, what's good? Look at him as he's talking. And he looked down or he looked to the side because he's hiding something. Because he's sweet. So like those LDBC dudes, dude, just sweet. You see what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, I'm picking Loma because I believe the experience and the patience is going to be able to break down Theo. And I think he's going to break Theo down. You understand what I'm saying? He's not going to, you know, knock him out, stop him, but he's going to break him down. I think he may be able to get him to have the towel be thrown in depending on the punches and how it goes down. But I believe Theo is going to have a lot of pressure, and he's going to be a guy that's anxious and want to swing for the fences, and that's going to be his downfall. So your boy, the Prediction King, CBT, Kaz, Rubotin Talk, picking your boy, Lomachenko. You see what I'm saying? The Matrix. So we're going to go live, go to the next video, rock with your boy, subscribe to the channel. I can't wait for this one, man.